Welcome to Logic First. In this video, let's discuss about finding a subarray with a given sum. The problem statement is that we are given with an input array of unsorted non-negative integers and also a sum. Within this array, we have to find a continuous subarray that matches the given sum. Considering this input array, the required sum is given as 10. On scanning this array, we can notice that the elements 4, 5, and 1 adds to 10. So we have to print the corresponding indexes of these elements 3 and 5. Between these indexes, we are able to find the given sum. The function that we write should return 1 if the subarray is found. If not, return 0. The technique that we are going to use here is known as the sliding window technique. We are going to make use of a variable called current sum and start accumulating the numbers one by one from the beginning of the array like this. We are going to do this as long as this current sum is less than the required sum. At first it is 2. So we are adding one more number and checking the result now. It is 5. It is still less than 10. So we are adding one more number. It is 7 now. Since it is less than 10, we are adding one more number to check. Now the sum is exceeding the required sum. We have now considered the first 4 numbers to be present in our subarray, but the sum is now exceeding. Our job is to find a continuous subarray. So since we have to proceed further to check whether we are able to find the required sum later in the array, we have to remove the elements from the beginning of the array. We should remove the elements from the beginning of the subarray until the sum becomes less than the required sum. Now just on removing the first element 2, the sum is now less than the required sum. Now we can add one more element to check if we are able to find a matching sum. So we are going ahead and adding the next number in the array. On adding 5, we get 14. Again, the sum has exceeded. So we have to try removing the elements from the beginning of the array. First, we are removing 3. The sum is 11. It is still more than the required sum. So we have to remove one more element from the beginning. We are removing 2 as well. Now the sum becomes 9, which is less than the required sum. On adding 1, we get 10, the required sum. So we can stop here and print the results. This is the subarray that we have found. So we have to print the starting index and the ending index of that subarray and also return 1 since we have found the array. What we are doing is just add the numbers one by one from the beginning as long as the sum is less than the required sum. If it exceeds, then try removing the elements from the beginning of the array until the sum is less than the required sum. We can continue doing this until we are able to find a matching sum. To implement this, we need to scan each of the element in the input array using a loop. Just add each element to the current sum. We need this new variable. We have to initialize it to 0 as well before the loop. We have to compare the current sum that we have calculated to the required sum. If they match, we can then print the results and return 1. While printing results, we have to mention what is the start as well as the end index of the subarray that we have found. Since we are taking one element at a time from the array, once we have found a subarray that matches the required sum, 1 is the ending element of this subarray. Since this is the current element of the loop that we are processing, the end index can easily be given with the help of I, the loop variable itself. We need to have a variable called start and keep track of what is the starting element of the subarray that we are considering. Initially, we can make it as 0 since we are starting from the beginning of the array. We will keep track of start in this step. If the current sum that we have calculated is greater than the required sum, we should remove the elements in the beginning of the subarray. We need start here as well. What we do is, to remove the elements from the beginning, we simply have to subtract the beginning element from the current sum, right? The beginning element will be given by start index, so just subtract the element at that index from the current sum. And also, we have to increment start. Since we have removed that element from the subarray, now start has to progress to point to next element. We have to remove not just one element from the array, but as many elements as required until the sum becomes less than the required sum. Outside the loop, after scanning all the elements in the array, we can print that result is not found and we can return 0. If any match was found, we would have already returned 1. So outside the loop, we can do this. Let's see C++ implementation for this. We receive the input array, the size of the array, as well as the required sum as arguments. We need three variables, current sum to calculate the sum of the subarray, and the starting index has to be tracked, the starting index of the subarray, and a loop variable. We don't need any additional arrays here. We just need to keep track of the starting index of the subarray as well as the sum of the subarray, just two integer variables. We need to scan each and every element present in the input array, starting from the 0th index till the size. The first thing that we do is to add the element to current sum. If the current sum matches the required sum, we can just print the start and the end index. The start will be given by the variable start and I will give the end index. We can return 1. If the current sum is greater than the required sum, we have to remove the elements from the beginning of the subarray. To do that, we are just subtracting the element at the starting index from the current sum. That's how we remove the elements from the beginning. We also have to keep track of the starting index by incrementing it. Since we have removed the element present at the start index from the current sum, now the element next to this has become the starting element, so that's why we are incrementing it. We have to keep doing this as long as the current sum is greater than the required sum, not just for one element, so that's why we have a while loop here. Finally, outside the loop, we can print that no array is found and return 0. I will leave the link for the code in the description box. The time complexity of this technique is O of n. Considering this array, if the required sum is just 5, first we add this element. Since it is greater than the required sum, we immediately remove it. Similarly, add this and then remove this. If we do this for all the elements in the array, then the time is 2n, which can be considered as O of n time complexity. Don't get misguided by the two loops present there. The while loop is just for removing the elements that we have already added. So even if we remove all the elements that we are adding, at max it is just 2n. So that's why we have O of n time complexity. This technique does not work for negative numbers. If you take this example, say the required sum is 4, we add 5. Since it is greater than 4, we immediately remove the element and move on to the next element. We will actually miss this subarray, which is the required result. The basic assumption that we are making with this technique is that on adding each subsequent element, the sum will keep increasing. If it exceeds, we can remove the beginning elements to reduce the sum. But that is not the case with the negative numbers. So this code will not work for negative numbers. Thank you for listening.